host for the 9 to 5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel, and I'm back again with another edition of Let's Play Classic featuring Grand Theft Auto 5. Story mode. In the previous stream, I play, of course, as Franklin, Michael, and Trevor. Michael is having problems with his family, distancing themselves from him because of his erratic and psychotic and impulsive behavior ever since Trevor came back into his life. While Franklin and Trevor have their own situations and stories, Trevor had done some heist reconnaissance with Wade's cousin Floyd to set up for a heist that he believes is taken at the port of Los Santos. So this stream is going to be, of course, for 3 hours, but the emphasis is I'm going to be doing some heist prep work for the three characters, but particularly with Michael and Franklin, in which they're going to have to improve on their aviation and marksmanship skills. So with all that said, do me a favor, grab a snack, grab a drink, grab whatever. It's time for Let's Play Classic Thinking featuring Grand Theft Auto 5. This is going to be Gaming Livestream Walkthrough Episode 4 on the 9 to 5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. So, without any further ado, let's get it on. And once again, I'd like to thank any and everyone who's watching this stream, whether on replay or watching live with me. I greatly appreciate it and hope you are following and subscribing. So we're going to be entering into story mode here. There's Michael. So everybody's left the house. Michael is just a lonely man and an empty home.
Tracy, baby, you called?
Yeah, look, Dad, we're worried.
I'm worried too. I really want to see you.
Well, I don't want to see you. You need help. Like, serious help. And if you don't get it, you're gonna be killed.
Tracy, I love you. But you don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
I tried, Daddy. That's all I could do.
See, he is falling out with his family, unfortunately. Let's drive around. Trevor.
Mike, we both know your flying ain't so good, so get some air time at the flight school before we move on this, or I'll be angry.
Yeah, let's go for some flight school, because like, we're doing heist prep. So let's go to flight school at the airport, the Los Santos airport. off to flight school. So this one, Mikey goes to flight school. Kind of mundane not listening to music. But I don't want to accidentally, you know, because this game does have a lot of licensed music, I don't want to accidentally flip on the station, so I'm not taking any chances. Check, check. Just wanted to check the audio, making sure everyone heard my voice, because the past few streams ago, several streams ago, I went live without the mic working, so I do not want to run into that again. Just a quick.
Too close.
I should mention that the actor who plays Michael in Grand Theft Auto 5 has long since started his streaming YouTube channel. That's of course his actor Ned Luke, who plays Michael DeSanta in Grand Theft Auto 5. He is actually streaming Grand Theft Auto 5 as we speak. And one unfortunate incident is that he gets a call to indicate that he had been swatted by somebody who played a prank on him because of his leaked IP address. And I think it was uncool and unfortunate, and someone actually sent the actual SWAT team, I mean for real, to his home. I mean, that's, like I said, that's not cool at all. They wouldn't like it if someone sent the SWAT team to them, you know? So why do it on somebody else? I like how you can drive on the wrong side of the street and not get arrested. I mean, at least get the cops coming after you. Well, in Mafia 2, if you're driving on the wrong side of the street, the police will come after you on account of that, or yeah, I guess if you're driving too fast. Stairs. Look at that. Time to get my wings. I'm driving around in a freaking loaner car. Same voice actor as the voice of Trevor. More likely, that's Stephen Ogg, the voice of Trevor, the performer who plays Trevor.
We're gonna start with a basic takeoff. Hold the throttle all the way
down. Even his voice
to
sounds like Trevor.
And pull back on the stick to take off. You can retract your landing gear once you're a safe distance above the ground. Congratulations, pilot. You are now airborne. Now, navigate through those checkpoints marked on. That wasn't one for the highlights.
Oh, I fucked up. Try this again.
We're gonna start with a basic takeoff. Hold the throttle all the way down to pick up speed, and pull back on the stick to take off. You can retract your landing gear once you're a safe distance above the ground. Congratulations, pilot!
two are now airborne. Now, navigate through those checkpoints marked on your radar, and we can move on to the next lesson. That was a good start. Well done.
Okay. That's phase one. Runaway landing. Learn how to safely land on a runaway. This is very important.
Now I'm going to have you attempt a safe landing on the runway. You won't have many chances to get this wrong, so please follow my instructions very closely. Start reducing the plane's altitude gradually so you're just above the runway as you approach. Be sure to deploy the landing gear before you reach the runway. Start to decelerate while you're still in the air, but be careful not to stall the engines. Executed like a pro! Now let's get the plane off the runway. Taxi over to the marked area and come to a complete stop. That was an excellent landing. Very well done.
Inverted flight.
In this lesson, you're going to be performing a couple of different stunts. We'll start you out with a few barrel rolls. And if that goes well, you can take a crack at flying upside down. All right, pilot. It's time for us to get a little crazy. First, I want you to get some altitude and head for that checkpoint marked at the end of the runway. Good. Okay, let's see what you got. On my mark, perform a barrel roll by pulling your flight stick to the left or right. Okay, perform a barrel roll. Stones of steel! I like it. Now let's try a few of those in a row. Level out your plane and get ready. I want to see you do three barrel rolls in a row on my signal. Watch your altitude on this one. Okay, perform three barrel rolls in a row. Very nice! Are you getting dizzy in there yet? Go ahead and level out the plane again. Now let's see how you do upside down. On my word, roll over the plane and hold it steady. Okay, roll the plane upside down. Hold the plane upside down for several seconds. Roll the plane right side up. Great work out there today. I'll teach you some more moves next time.
Knife fight. This is gonna be a trip.
This lesson will help you build your stick and rudder skills. You have to keep your plane steady while rolled over on either side. Perfecting this trick will really come in handy in the later lessons. Take off and head for the checkpoint marked at the runway. Then, I'll talk you through it. A knife is one of the harder moves. You'll have to keep your wings steady and use your rudders to maintain altitude. When I give you the signal, I want you to try to hold a knife edge with your plane. Okay, perform a knife edge. Perfect. Now hold that position. Don't forget to use your rudders to maintain altitude.
Holy fucking shit. Fuck.
plane. Good. Let's see if you can do the same thing on the other side. On my mark, roll your plane over to the opposite side and hold the position. Okay, perform a knife edge on the other side. Level out the plane.
Oh, shit. I fucked up. Try this again.
Take off and head for the checkpoint marked at the runway. Then, I'll talk you through it. When I give you the signal, I want you to try to hold a knife edge with your plane. Okay, perform a knife edge. Perfect. Now hold that position. Don't forget to use your rudders to maintain altitude. Take off and head for the checkpoint marked at the runway. Then, I'll talk you through it. A knife is one of the harder moves. You'll have to keep your wings steady and use your rudders to maintain altitude. When I give you the signal, I want you to try to hold a knife edge with your plane. Okay, perform a knife edge. Perfect. Now hold that position. Don't forget to use your rudders to maintain altitude.
Ah, shit.
Take off and head for the checkpoint marked at the runway. Then, I'll talk you through it. A knife is one of the harder moves. You'll have to keep your wings steady and use your rudders to maintain altitude. When I give you the signal, I want you to try to hold a knife edge with your plane. Okay, perform a knife edge. Perfect. Now hold that position. Don't forget to use your rudders to maintain altitude. Level out the plane. Good. Let's see if you can do the same thing on the other side. On my mark, roll your plane over to the opposite side and hold the position. Okay, perform a knife edge on the other side. Level out the plane. Well, you're definitely making some progress. Well done.
I don't care for 100% completion. I just want to get through this. Flat hatting, wherever that is.
This obstacle course is designed to teach you how to get better control over your turn. The course goes around the harbor, and you have to stay low to make the checkpoint. You'll need to use your rudders to help you make some of the sharp turns.
That's the left and right shift buttons. If you're on a controller.
I want you to use everything you've learned so far to navigate this course as fast as you can. Watch your altitude, though. This is really a test of how low you can go and how well you can maneuver the plane.
So I gotta keep within the
You need to stay the on altimeter. The runway during takeoff.
Altimeter. Oh, fuck. Get low. Oh, fuck. Too low. Gotta keep under the altimeter. That's
I want
that
you
arrow.
To use everything you've learned so far to navigate this course as fast as you can. Watch your altitude, though. This is really a test of how low you can go and how well you can maneuver the plane.
So, below the altimeter meter. Shit.
I want you to use everything you've learned so far to navigate this course as fast as you can. Watch your altitude, though. This is really a test of how low you can go and how well you can maneuver the plane.
Okay, now to the finish line.
You made decent time, but I think you can do better.
Fuck that. I just want to get through this. Touchdown.
I'm going to begin decelerating while you are still airborne for a smoother touchdown. Then, once you're on the ground, the brakes should bring you to a full stop very quickly. Okay, do you see your checkpoint marked on the radar? You're gonna practice an emergency landing on that bridge, straight ahead.
On the bridge.
Slow your approach as you descend onto the road. If you touch down smoothly, your plane is gonna stop pretty fast.
Slow down.
Oh. Shit! You gotta keep it steady on the runway. On the bridge.
Okay, do you see your checkpoint marked on the radar? You're gonna practice an emergency landing on that bridge, straight ahead.
Let's get in straight.
Slow your approach as you descend onto the road. If you touch down smoothly, your plane is gonna stop pretty fast.
Ah, shit. Splash down. Man, I keep fucking this up. Gotta concentrate.
Okay, do you see your checkpoint marked on the radar? You're gonna practice an emergency landing on that bridge, straight ahead. Slow your approach as you descend onto the road. If you touch down smoothly, your plane is gonna stop pretty fast. Not too bad, but there's still some room for improvement.
That counts. As long as I can land a plane safely, that's all I care about.
The inside loop can be a little disorienting, so we'll see how you do under pressure. Make sure you start this stunt from a completely level position. It's also important to remember to pull your stick back as straight as you can so you don't get thrown into a spiral. Take off and head for the marker at the end of the runway. Some pilots find these moves particularly tricky, so it might take you a few tries. Make sure your plane is straightened out before you attempt an inside loop. On my mark, pull back hard on the flight stick and hold it. Okay, perform an inside loop. Get ready to level out the plane when you're near the end of the loop.
Still again.
That wasn't quite there. Level out and retry the stunt from the beginning. Quite there. Level out and retry the stunt from the beginning. for a rookie. Let's try it again. Just like before. Steady the plane first, wait for my signal, and then pull back hard on the flight stick. Okay, perform an inside loop. Get ready to level out the plane when you're near the end of the loop. Now we're talking! You're doing good so far. I think we can squeeze in one more stunt. We'll combine the inside loop with the barrel roll to perform a roll off the top. Start with an inside loop, but only go halfway. When you're fully inverted, then roll the plane over. Now, when I give you the go-ahead, yank the flight stick back as hard as you can. Ready? Perform a roll off the top. That wasn't quite there. Level out and retry the stunt from the beginning. Now roll the plane right side up. I told you this stunt was tough. You could do with more practice, and I could always do with more.
Let's try it again.
Take off and head for the marker at the end of the runway. Some pilots find these moves particularly tricky, so it might take you a few tries. You need to stay on the runway during takeoff. Always make sure your plane is straightened out before you attempt an inside loop. On my mark, pull back hard on the flight stick and hold it. Okay, perform an inside loop. Get ready to level out the plane when you're near the end of the loop. That wasn't too bad for a rookie. Let's try it again. Just like before. Steady the plane first, wait for my signal, and then pull back hard on the flight stick. Okay, perform an inside loop. Get ready to level out the plane when you're near the end of the loop. Now we're talking! You're doing good so far. I think we can squeeze in one more stunt. We'll combine the inside loop with the barrel roll to perform a roll off the top. Start with an inside loop, but only go halfway. When you're fully inverted, then roll the plane over. Now, when I give you the go-ahead, yank the flight stick back as hard as you can. Ready? Perform a roll off the top. Now, roll the plane right side up. Not bad! You did all right out there.
Making some progress here, folks.
You've been doing so well in the plane, we're going to put you in a helicopter for this lesson. There are a few more controls than the stunt plane, but it's a little more forgiving. Try to finish the obstacle course without bursting into a ball of fire. And sign the waiver.
Helicopters are obviously easy.
Let's go on a short tour of the city, and we'll see how well you handle the chopper. Follow the marked course, and remember, I'm looking for maneuverability, but also speed. in the city now. Watch out for streetlights and buildings.
Looks like I won't make gold, but it's okay. Anything below bronze is failure, so let's try this one last time.
Let's go on a short tour of the city, and we'll see how well you handle the chopper. Follow the marked course, and remember, I'm looking for maneuverability, but also speed. You've got this. This is the checkpoint.
damn it!
Another try. I'm sure you'll.
Fuck that.
Let's go on a short tour of the city, and we'll see how well you handle the chopper. Follow the marked course, and remember, I'm looking for maneuverability, but also speed. Pretty well. This is another helicopter lesson, but with a real emphasis on speed this time. Finish the obstacle course around the city before the timer runs out, and try not to crash. At the end of the course, you'll be required to safely land your helicopter.
Let's go.
Remember, this course is all about speed. And to maximize acceleration, keep the nose of the helicopter tipped. Just bear in mind that you're also losing altitude when the nose is pointed down. Looking solid.
You've got this!
Good job! Bring the helicopter down gently onto the helipad. All right, not too bad. You made decent time.
Yeah, barely. Cutting it close with this one. Skydiving, oh, this is gonna be fun.
We've taught you how to fly a helicopter. Now you're gonna learn how to jump out of one. Aim for the landing target and pull your chute when you get close to the ground. The parachute is difficult to control, so slow your approach and give yourself extra time to correct.
Here we go.
Hope you aren't afraid of heights. Aim for the target and deploy your parachute when you start getting close to the ground.
Thank you.
that bad.
Good. Drop zone.
This lesson will involve skydiving onto a moving target, so I hope you brought a change of underwear. The target will be circling around the runway, so watch it carefully and pay attention to the route. It may take several tries, but once you get this down, you'll be terrorizing drivers all over Los Santos. The drop zone is on the back of a moving truck, so take your time maneuvering with your parachute. It's better to pull your chute early than late. It'll give you more time to track the target and try to match its speed.
I didn't have to land on a trailer either. Now, the final one. Earn your wings. Then I pass.
Flight your
school.
Final lesson is going to combine extremely dangerous stunts with highly populated city areas in an assault course that will put everything you've learned during your time at flight school to the test. For your sake, I hope you've been practicing knifing and flying upside down.
Yeah, with this test. Here we go. I expect
to
fail.
I want you to take your very best shot at this obstacle course. There are going to be special gates that will require you to fly upside down or knife through them.
When it's nighttime in a game, it's hard for me to see.
Since it's marked green, you'll have to perform a knife through it.
No matter how I have to adjust the brightness, it's difficult for me to see.
Miss! Come on! Keep your head. you that one.
Show up. Fuck me up.
I want you to take your very best shot at this obstacle course. There are going to be special gates that will require you to fly upside down or knife through them.
Finally got it.
This next gate is blue, so you're gonna have to fly through it upside down. You're making up your own course now?
Shit.
I want you to take your very best shot at this obstacle course. There are going to be special gates that will require you to fly upside down or knife through them. Do this. gate is blue, so you're gonna have to fly through it upside down. What happened to that checkpoint?
Now we're going to go to the firing range for Franklin.
Man, I'm drunk. But shit, I ain't getting drunker.
So we want one with a shooting range, an ammunition with a shooting range. That's this. The closest one, so we'll go there. This is Franklin's special ability, which is speed time, I guess we can call it, which allows him to make sharp turns when doing evasion, like making him a convenient wheelman for heists. Works in the same way as Michael's bullet time, similar to that of Max Payne. Also avoid head-on collisions using this special ability, but when it wears off, you gotta be careful because you'll have to slow down coming out of it. So this one's got a shooting range.
I was wondering if you'd be back in again. Listening to you and those two friends of yours bantering back and forth, it was so cool. It was like I was in a movie or a music video or something.
Man, what are you talking about?
I love the hip-hop. P.G. Jackson, MC Clip.
That ain't real hip-hop.
No, of course not. I mean, what would I know? I barely exist outside this store. I just feel immediately less cool when you walk in. I don't even want to ask, although I kind of do.
Good, let's keep it that way.
Be good.
Man, fuck you. Time to go for the shooting range. Look at this. Triads or the concave. Gotta get a certain score to pass. Oh. We gotta aim high. Let's try this again. We can change views. Ooh, I'm doing terrible. Four. So we got 15 targets to hit. See, that's much better. Makes sense to go in first person view. Aim at the sights. Failure. I am sucking really bad at this. I'm gonna give this 3 more tries. go through this quickly. Let's take it one more time. Aim at the sights, aim at the sights. Aim at the sights, aim at the sights. You know what? I think I'll do it one more time with this one. Hey, what is that? This would be easy. I'm gonna do this one over. Let's get ready. I guess every 15 rounds use reload. This is much better, much better. Fuck this. I guess I'll give this one more. Just one more with this gun. Gun time. Take that. No, let's try this one. Get ready, get ready, get ready. Yeah. Oh. 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 Shoot. Shoot. One more with this pump shotgun test. Let's try this again. Hmm. Ah, fuck it. This a light machine gun? This doesn't seem light to me. It just takes forever to reload. I'm just doing one test with this. Fuck it. Real good. Shut this shit up. Real gun is easy. This has a slow reload time. First shot. I think I'll do one more of this, unless I pass it. One more time. Missed opportunity, but over. Ah, fuck it. Yeah, missed. Perfect. That's how you get them. Get them in a bunch. Oh shit. Close. I'll do it one more time. Real gun is so much fun. But only known drawback is a per shot. It's a 1 minute. I mean, you have to reload per shot. Once a shot. Get the targets when they line up against each other. When they're close to each other, pull the trigger. Especially when they move like that. That way you'll rack up more. Mm-hmm. Fuck it. Alright, that's it. It's not practice for me. Now let's get on the prepping.
Your life must be so exciting.
Say again?
I can't even imagine. Gang signs, initiations, dropping homies.
I'll drop your ass, you don't shut the fuck up. Now let's get back with Trevor.
We are Scooter Brothers! Scooter Brother!
Yeah, stop so I can shoot you. Ha ha ha! Time to do some heist prep time. So Wade is just all submersible. So part of the heist prep, get the mini sub. So let's get on with that. Look at the little ass Scooter.
Scooter Brothers!
Look at that Scooter build. I mean Scooter view. Look at that. That was our chopper. The cargo bob. Also a cargo bob as well. Yeah, but he's not in the cargo bob. Let's see what's closer. Yeah, the mini sub, we'll grab that. We'll grab that straight away. Yeah. Well, you can't expect a scooter to go that fast. I'm surprised they permit these on national freeways. Let's go topside. Look at that. Look at the rabbit.
Look at the bunny. Look at the bunny. Look at the cute little bunny rabbit. Look at that.
Okay, let's steal a vehicle. Still something that's much faster. Let's go pick a vehicle. Alright, just, you know what, just call for a cab. Fuck it, just call for a cab. How much money you got? $54, man, no. Land stalker. Still a vehicle. Yeah, we'll take that. Hold up, fuck that. Ah, you ran me over. Nearly. Next time we're gonna use a shotgun. Break the cops.
You should have run away.
Here come the fuzz. Here come the fuzz. Oh yeah, let's take that dude, take that buggy. Get out the fucking car. You're getting robbed, that's what. Get the fuck out.
You fucker! You fucker!
Come and catch me now, fuckers. Ha 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 ha. Play with the sticky yucky yucky yucky. Now look at us rolling over. Look at that. Rolling over. Let's play grenade chicken. Let's play hand grenade chicken. take the high road.
Check.
Whatever.
Yep, he's still alive. I nearly crippled him.
Slow down!
Fuck you! Okay, I lost him. Perfect. I can continue on with the plan.
So there's not going to be any GTA updates until Tuesday, I should say, because they're going to be releasing the new DLC for Grand Theft Auto Online, which of course is a business which involves boosting vehicles and stripping the parts and then reselling them, like a chop shop type business for luxury vehicles, and it's going to be the reappearing. I love when and the character in the GTA universe makes an appearance. In this case, it's going to be Yusuf Amir. Remember him from Grand Theft Auto, The Ballad of Gay Tony, or, you know, from Grand Theft Auto 4, the downloadable content originally from 2009. Well, he's coming back. Annoying, the equally annoying but the most fun character, one of them, is coming back to GTA Online. Yusuf Amir, but chop shop business. So, look forward to that next Tuesday. Okay. Oh, silence one. News about drawing any attention to the NPCs. The Merryweather people. Fine. That's why I love you. I think there might be an achievement for not making a sound. I mean, for not killing anyone or drawing attention.
You crazy son of a bitch! I'm getting the cops down here.
Oh no, you're not! Stop. Oh, too late. Fuck it. Take this in. Get out of here.
We have a trespasser reported at the Justice Terminal. Requesting a unit to investigate. Code 3.
I don't think so. Let's get out of here. Or at the very least, I did, you know, gunfire. It can't catch me now. Yeah, but you can't catch me now. Lost me, suckers. In the submersible. What was that? Oh, killer whales. Look at the killer whales.
Fine. Got that submarine we talked about. You gotta help me store it for a few days. Floyd, don't go quiet on me or I'll come around and I'll, well, we both know what I'm talking about.
Okay, all right. Bring it around to Pier 400 at the Western Docks.
On my way.
Look, I'll have a truck to bring you around the warehouse.
What's this? The union man doing an honest day's work?
There's nothing honest about this, sir. But this is a dishonest day's work, if ever I've seen one.
Hey, we're not hurting anyone.
No, but no one except whoever.
research. My Meriwether Security Consulting friend. They'd be on trial for human rights offenses if the U.S. government didn't protect all its contractors from any kind of suit, military or civilian. They're immune from prosecution, and they behave like they are. Murdering, stealing, high on power, guns and anabolic steroids. Lucky bastards.
Look, I don't know about that stuff.
Oh, you're right. You don't. Meriwether are employed by the richest, greediest scum on the planet to shit on the poorest and the neediest. So we are going to enjoy shitting on them.
Oh, great. Well, look forward to that.
Okay, well, that's more like it. Floyd, you there?
Yes, sir. I'm on the crane. The surface, and I'll bring you shoreside.
All right.
I'm here.
Oh, Jesus.
It's just down the road. Los Santos Marine, past the shipyards.
Is that sub covered properly?
It'll be fine if we just get there.
Are you being short with me?
No, sir. I'm certainly not being short. I'm just not used to this kind of pressure.
If you turn a crew onto a score, you gotta be ready for the heat that comes with it.
I didn't turn anyone on to anything. You threatened and cajoled and tricked me.
You don't want to cut? Just walk away.
I can't walk away. You're robbing my workplace and running the show from my home.
Deborah's home. No cut for you, no cut for Deborah.
Trevor is convinced that what he's about to steal is a substantial amount of money for the score.
Drive it under there. You can pull up.
Now we just gotta steal the cargo box.
You're sure it'll be okay there?
Sure.
All right. If you're wrong, I'll eat your sweetmeats. Get out of here.
Your sweetmeats. Probably means your kidneys. Switch to Michael and have him steal the cargo bob.
Get a cab?
Not a problem. A driver's on the way.
Great.
there's the cab. They gotta press in the hole to get in. Tap. Go.
Hey, my man, where you going?
Fort Sancudo.
Sure thing, man.
Let's skip it. Pay a little extra.
I'm gonna have to drop you here, man.
I should have took some armor, but it's okay. I got sniper rifles, all that good shit. Probably by helicopter. First, we're gonna need to get some body armor. So we're down to the last hour of this stream, folks. I should go to the airport. Still a pledge. Or go to that helicopter tour place and steal a helicopter. But I'm gonna need a parachute as well.
You need a receipt for taxes?
Oh, parachutes are not available. Shit. What am I gonna do?
I don't like people getting too close. Either I would just use Trevor.
I don't care if you ain't washed it.
Holy shit. never seen this before. I like it. Oops. Catch me now. Oops. That was dumb. Death wish and a short fuse.
Oh no!
know she took over, huh? Too late for that. Nah, I'm cruel. Taking a helicopter that's still a helicopter. I'm gonna land right next to her. In case anybody wonders, this is the helicopter that was taken by Trevor from the previous extraction mission at FIB. You know, the Ferdinand K mission, where we extract him from IAA custody and bring him to FIB custody.
You are flying in restricted airspace. Turn around immediately.
You got it. Make sure you don't hit the thing when you fail the mission. At least with helicopters, you don't have to fly a certain altitude. Uh-oh. Fuck it, just leave.
Went into an air base and stole a chopper. Are we ready to go on this thing?
If it's a heavy lift chopper, then yeah, I'll get everything ready and I'll call you.
All right.
I'm gonna take a short break once we land this, and then we're gonna continue with the heist, the merry with the heist. Like stealing candy off a bunch of babies. Turbines are about to give out. Come on. Little bitch. No. Ah, fuck. Let's retry this shit. The turbine gave out. Okay, this one should be fine because there's no damage.
He's an unwieldy thing if Michael don't get those lessons.
First person view.
How you doing, Trev?
Fine! For a guy who just went into an air base and stole...
I heard the conversation anyway. Doesn't matter if I skip it. But you know what does matter? To me, at least, if you like the content that you see, follow, subscribe to the 9to5 Blah Blah Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel for more Let's Play Classics featuring Grand Theft Auto 5, Mad Max, Sleeping Dogs, Watch Dogs, Assassin's Creed, and many others. I would really appreciate that. Incident this time. Say it, better take the helicopter.
Everything. Floyd don't think it's a good idea for us to meet at the condo, so maybe we should...
Tell Floyd it is a good idea to meet at the condo. It's a great idea. And tell him we need chips and dip and prostitutes.
I guess we're about to go with the heist. So let's get on with the heist. So with the heist intro, that's when I'm gonna go and get some, that's when I'm gonna go take a break. So we're at the home stretch with this screen. First person view is so cool in a helicopter, maybe even a plane. Especially if you're doing dogfights in like in GTA Online or in story mode. Spooky Beach, which is Venice Beach in real life.
One of you shits must be here.
Hello, Trevor. I missed you.
Hello, Wade. I missed you, too.
Hello, Trevor.
Oh, there. Hey, Hot Lips, where you been hiding?
No, nowhere.
I got a knot the size of a baseball in here, all right? Needs a little, loosening up, all right?
Oh.
Massage me, motherfucker! Good, good.
Trevor's hard at work, huh?
Where's the surrogate child?
Who?
The boy! The stars in his eyes.
Not like that.
What's not like that?
Oh, hey! Hey there, you and him, the old father-son issues? Gives me the fucking creeps.
How's the leg rub?
Oh, it's excellent! You want to go?
No, I'm good, though.
Hey, I called you boys here to discuss this job that I've been planning.
The fuck are you talking about?
Shut the fuck up, Michael, all right? You owe me.
Hey, did you talk to Lester?
I called him. He's in the hospital or something, all right? We keep him out and we get 20%. Well, unless, of course, you go states again and have me arrested.
Hey, it wasn't like that.
Better not have been.
I mean, like, you give a fuck.
Oh, see, I give a fuck, Michael. It's a position.
They've had a
fucking viewpoint, all right? Like
an
God,
easy history
like
with
evolution,
each other.
Like anything else. Sunshine, boredom, lies, that's what we got. Other people, they have other worlds. But for me, I'm like a vulture just circling the desert looking for fucking corpses, you know? A carrion-eating motherfucker. Do you understand that?
Wow. Woo! Bravo, you fucking idiot.
Man, I still don't get the score. What's the fucking plan?
We got Floyd, all right? Now, Floyd's got, not the, fuck, get out of here, all right? Now, Floyd here works at the port. He puts me onto Meriwether Security, who were running some tests out at sea for Uncle Sam. We're gonna take whatever it is they're testing. Now, got a couple buyers lined up, I guarantee, no problems, no major heat. Let's get going, all right? Slightly past it vibe to an airfield where I got a sub, got a chopper, I got everything we need. All right, let's do this, you fucks. Sandy Shores Airfield, bro.
Sandy Shores. That's quite a distance.
What's with this guy?
Man, I didn't realize we was going all the way out there either.
I've been told your generation are work shy, repeatedly. But this is the first time I've seen it for myself. You won't leave the city for the biggest take of your life?
Man, it's not like that.
Well, what is it like, huh? You think the world owes you a living? You want money and respect, but you won't cross the street to get it.
That useless millennial shit is more of a middle-class thing. Where I'm from, hustling is still hustling. And going halfway across the state is still, going halfway across the state.
Yeah, well, Sandy Shores is the global headquarters for TP Inc., okay? So we gotta make the trip.
TP Inc.?
Trevor Phillips Industries. My company.
Industries or Incorporated? If it's TP Inc., it'd be Trevor Phillips Incorporated. Just saying.
You're mocking me! Nice! Is it so strange that I've made a success of my life? I know that wasn't what you wanted for me when you ran off, but still.
Trevor!
It's a business, Michael. An honest American business, and there aren't many of them left. Hey, you know this airstrip we're going to? We're managing it.
Yeah. I hate to think what you did to the last managers.
The lost MC LLP experienced an unexpected downturn. We had to step in.
The Lost Motorcycle Club. Yeah, you're a serious business.
Yeah, we gotta take the long, mundane trip.
I cannot believe this. The hard-working entrepreneur is getting shit from a guy so lazy he retired in his 30s. And then from this other guy whose sense of entitlement is so strong, he asks how far we had to travel when he's offered a job he ain't even qualified to do. This is why the country is screwed. There's not enough me's, there's too many you's.
Yeah, a country full of you's. That's just what this world needs.
Shit would get done. It would be Darwinian.
Hey, look, dude, we're helping you out. But if you think you'd be better off on your own...
No. Hey, look, hey. God, look at
that. Let's see what the squeeze has been 16 minutes, so let's hustle this.
We have a score to take. There is profit to be made. I mean, don't that beat getting picked up by G-Men and forced to work for free?
Yeah, all right. Talk us through exactly what's going on.
We're going out to Sandy Shores.
I know that part.
My guys will meet us there. They'll have the submarine. I'm gonna get into said submarine that... Wait, hold on. You had the flying lessons, right?
Hey, I came prepared. I didn't know what I was preparing for, but I'm feeling pretty confident in the air.
Good.
Hey, what's the next part of the plane?
There's an army chopper at the airfield. You're both getting into it. Michael's flying. Gonna take off, pick up the submarine with me in it, and fly it out to a point off the coast. You're gonna drop me into the ocean. I'll pilot the sub down to find the device the government's been testing. I'll get it, surface, you'll fly me back to the airfield.
What kind of device?
What kind doesn't matter. How much will be paid for it does matter.
These are government scientists we're robbing.
I said at the condo. The tests are being run by Meriwether Security Consulting.
Ah, yes, the mercenaries. Fresh from fighting our secret oil wars. Should be very relaxing.
If stealing a prototype like this from the government was relaxing, then everyone would be doing it. As it stands, we've got an opportunity to mint some serious coin.
Oh, whoa. There's easier ways. And this sounds extreme, T, even for you. Can't we rethink? I mean, how deep are you into it?
How deep? I've got a sub, I've got a big helicopter. I've been researching this since I got to LS. Those guys, Wade and his cousin Floyd, are expecting a paycheck. Same with my intel guy, Ron Jakowski, who is a damn sight better than Lester, I might add.
Okay, fine, I'll go along with it. Listen, Frank, if you want out, I understand.
No, I'm good. I can do with a paycheck.
That's the spirit!
You've been kind of reckless, homie.
What is this shit?
Hey, let's do this.
Hey! Hey, here's the sub. Floyd, wait. Wait in the hangar.
I guess this is our chopper.
Imagine what this would be like if you hadn't taken those flying lessons.
That's pretty good, I like.
You need to take off and hover low over the submarine. The rig on the chopper will connect to it. We are hooked up! You gotta drop me a couple clicks out to sea from Polito Cove.
Off to a shitty start here.
Oh! That looked painful! I don't feel pain! But if I did, oh yeah, that would have been painful. Roger that. Trevor, you got your company name sprayed all over this chopper. But, everything else about it says military. Yep, I got it from the military base. And there's all this military hardware in the back. Guns and whatnot. Mm-hmm, if this thing gets hot, they'll come in handy. Hey, I thought it wasn't getting hot. You said no major heat. That can guarantee it. It's a score, Michael. Even if you don't anticipate heat, you prepare for it. That's the code. That's why I don't take scores. Not anymore. I'm out of the game, man. What am I doing? Oh, really? You don't take scores? No, not anymore. What say you, Franklin? I say this is a conversation between you two. No. That wasn't you guys then at the Rockford Hills Jewel Store. Hey, that's right around the corner from my house, T. I might have been there buying something for Amanda.
I certainly
wasn't robbing it. Oh, okay, oh, my mistake. It was a pretty tight job, though, eh? I mean, the planning was there. They went in, right? They got out clean. I mean, there were some problems, but they kept their heads, right? Yeah, pulled it off. All right. It was us. Of course it was us. Any other clowns would be in Bolingbrook now. Nah, there were some weak points. I mean, whoever fed that cheesy line to the parking guy? That guy? Amateur! Yeah, show us how it's done then, T. If you're such a professional, this job will go great. Oh, it sure will.
They're just at each other's throats at this point. An uneasy history. Fly faster. Step with the time here. Here we go. Screw that. next to ascend and to descend.
Alrighty tidy, McFlighty, I'm down here. My phone's hooked up to the sensors on the sub. Bloop, bloop, bloop. I got an app here that should pick up the signal. It's relaying the diagnostics from this thing.
Come on, get to it, man. An ex-army helicopter hovering by this platform's gonna raise suspicions.
It's safer at the bottom of the ocean than it is strapped to the helicopter you're flying. Here it is. It's been secured to the seabed. I'll see if I can pry it loose.
So, in the last few minutes of the stream, folks, I want to thank everyone that's tuning in to this and watching this on replay.
Because I found this thing using an app on my phone, which means the private army guarding it can find it pretty easy, too. Ah, you gotta be joking me.
Thing does add weight.
Uh-oh! Merryweather boats coming right at us.
Oh.
Franklin, grab one of those guns and get those guys off our ass.
so easy to take them in the air when it was on the ground.
Right there! Some more Meriwether helicopters!
Ready to wrap this
up. What was that, T? I told you! That was Mary. Weather. Those choppers? And that ain't normal private security guard.
Yeah, you're right. I have it on good authority that they're actually a lizard army who've taken human form to do the bidding of the New World Order. I hope you can flip this thing fast. I don't want to see those reptile buddies of yours ever again.
Oh, shit.
The wire is going fucking crazy.
Oh, and good to see you, too. What's it been, huh? 10 years?
After this, the government won't care how long it's been. They're gonna put you and everyone you ever knew on their kill list. And you, I thought you would be smarter than this.
What'd I do?
Stealing a super weapon to sell to the Chinese.
Damn, T. This some nuke or some shit?
I thought you said you spoke to him.
Yeah, I did. Okay? Kind of. I mean, he was all woozy and shit. It doesn't matter, all right? It's done. We've got it.
Well, we could put it back. You drop it in the sea by the time they get a salvage operation together.
No!
Oh, so in the previous iteration of Battle 405, get this you another scenario score, where Lester is upset about the what Franklin, Michael, and Trevor
you
did.
Owe me!
He,
wait, get in that chopper!
Coming out of the hospital
listen
where
to whatever
you can
the
see
fucking
his
moron has to say.
Naked
okay.
In his right, hospital
on that
guard.
Note, I'm out of here. You won't be seeing me back here in a long time.
Hey,
so, unfortunately, this heist
score.
Is a bust.
Remember.
Man, I thought I was done not getting paid for these licks.
Hello? Me too.
Unfortunately, this was a bust. We're getting nothing for this. Huh. Yeah, well, how about it? He got home quick, didn't he? like to thank you for watching this edition of Let's Play Classic featuring Grand Theft Auto 5 on the 9to5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel. And do me a favor, if you like the content I'm bringing you, why not follow and subscribe to the 9to5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel for more Let's Play Classics featuring Grand Theft Auto 5, Assassin's Creed Syndicate, which I'm about to put out like about 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, which will be a short hour from now. And if you'd like to contribute to my channel, I do have a Patreon listed in the description. But until then, I'm Kill David for the 9to5 Outlaw Does Gaming YouTube and Twitch channel, and please, stay safe.